On this episode, we have our first international guest aboard Añejo. We take down our sails, ready for repair, and our solar panels arrive. But one decides to go swimming.
You're off the line, Alan.
Accident.
After our little mishap last week, Alan went cleaning this apartment in exchange for our cushions to get sewn professionally. And the end result? These are awesome.
And we just had another mail drop, and we shouldn't break these ones.
Two brand new 10-inch Luma handles. Amazon. Two-day delivery, you beauty.
Well, still working on that one. Don't give it up. Don't give it up.
So the plan is to get the new valve and fit it inside.
I'm feeling pretty deflated. Had a big day of service, three winches, completely took them apart. Put them back together, that was great. Success. Service the outboard motor, absolutely no problem. And this dinghy is absolutely giving us nothing but problem. It's old, we know that. It's got two leaky spots and I just cannot get it to repair. This is our life raft if things go, you know, go south. So it needs to be reliable. And I feel beaten by the dinghy. And I know it's just a dinghy, but another try and another try until I get it. Or I make the decision to get another one. We knew we were going to invest money in the boat. We knew we had to get it on par with safety-wise, and it hadn't been used in a few years. And we know it's a very good boat, and we're confident with it, but we knew it was going to eat the money, and we knew that the budget would only last so long. But then after that, I mean, how many things can you buy before you overspend and then you don't actually need these things? I don't. Just not feeling it today. Tomorrow's new. Let's try tomorrow.
The mail's just arrived, and this is our new GPS plotter, which currently we're going to use to display our screens on because they are a little bit sun-blessed and not looking too good. So instead of replacing those at $250 a piece, I need to replace three. I'm not doing that. I'm going to put it straight on our new one. So I ended up getting a B&G Zeus 2. So there's currently a Zeus 3 out, hence why they're clearing these ones out. Now the difference is pretty much nothing. They're all compatible. They can still do radar. They'll share charts. The only thing that the Zeus 2 didn't do, built-in Wi-Fi. And you can buy a Wi-Fi dongle if you really want to Wi-Fi it to your phone. We got this for less than half price. Delivered to my door for $735. And online they're going for $2,500.
We've got Atlas and Sky over for dinner. And what have you cooked for us, Sky?
Roasted Brussels sprouts and smothered chicken with rice.
Some bacon in there, bit of rice, and some smothered chicken. I hope all of you YouTube watchers can appreciate the subtitles if you're using them, because let me tell you, the last thing I want to be doing this morning is sitting here on the computer editing every single word that we speak into that microphone, because YouTube doesn't do a very good job of it, and Alain has to do it in French, I do the English one. But on a positive note, we're going to an NFL game tonight, and that gives me so much hope for the rest of the day. We got something to look forward to. We got pre-season tickets, $5 each, so it's affordable for us.
Hey, boy. What do you want to buy you?
Everything. Okay. Basically, all it was a small delamination, which is basically nothing to do with the structural. A very nifty air tool with a little grinding disc. And we have now grinded all of the delam out from here. And we've additionally done it in the next hatch there, which is one place there and one just under here. And I've got my glass cut into the shapes that we need it now. And we're just gonna lay down a couple of layers, so.
Okay, so team, where are we off to?
We're to the Superdome.
And what for?
Saints game.
Saints game.
Right.
Who's the number one team in the NFL?
Saints.
Saints, number one?
Yes, Saints is number one. Will always be number one. Who that?
Second line into that Super Bowl.
slow start today. I'm doing the more important things like registering our EPIRB to make sure that's good. The battery life is good until 2021 and it's registered in the States. So I'm basically trying to figure out how to register in the USA so that we know if we set it off, we can get rescued, which is fairly important. Now it's come to lunchtime. We've been working on our new video and we got hungry and Alain has just whipped up the most incredible looking sandwiches from nothing in the fridge. And it looks sensational. Bit of mustard in there, you absolute legend. Thank you.
We turn into a vegetarian though.
I don't think so. Our neighbor Skye invited us to her workshop where she creates Mardi Gras floats. This is a year-round process with multiple people building the sculptures for a one-day event.
So Ivor, are you doing a little bit of work?
Yeah, just we've got our Victron Energy MPPT chargers, and I opted to have a system that was basically able to run on separate sides. So we've got one charge controller for each solar panel so that we've got some redundancy if something breaks. So just putting them in now, the panels arrived today, and we can get some sun solar panel happening. And finally the solar panels arrived. We unloaded them, checked them for damage before signing the paperwork, ready for installing. In our sink, we have our freshwater tap and we have a little saltwater tap. And we bought the boat and I still haven't looked at it, given the other job's importance, and I thought today's the day. Alain's gone off to do a couple of hours work in exchange for some sewing for the cushions. So I'm having a bit of a look. We've got a little foot pump here, which comes through. And we just have our little ball valve. All I've done is double hose clamp everything, turn it to open so it's on salt water. The other side actually draws water from the shower, and that's where we're at. So I'm just going to give it a bit of a lubrication on the foot pump and we'll put it together and see how it goes. It'd be good. This is the moment of truth. It's a little foot pump under the sink, and as I squeeze down with my foot, let's have a look. Hey! Just going for a casual stroll. Checking out a few of the boats. And enjoying the time we have here because we're not too far from going. So this stuff here is called okja. Not sure how we're supposed to eat it. I looked at a few options. It's from here. So I'll let you know how it goes. That's our little grill tonight.
Headed out on a day trip to check out Skye's family property.
So our neighbour Skye brought us out to their childhood house, which got destroyed with some floods and rain, but one day they hope to repair it. But it's got a fair bit of work to be done. And I've just seen a copperhead snake just there in the shadows of the water. It was swimming around. So we're going to avoid that because that is not going to be a good afternoon if that happens. We haven't seen a gator while at this river. But it's a very common place to come noodling, to grab a catfish. When you put your arm in a hole, they'll grab it and then you can pull them out. So very, very cool little place.
On our way home, we stopped past Guy's dad's house for a nice feed.
That's the go. What type of trout is it?
It's a speckled trout, yeah.
And the sauce is mustard and hot sauce. And it's corn flour and...
It's corn flour and corn flour, white flour, half and half, and seasoning.
Oh, yeah.
And so I did it with it. I had that mustard. I did this for the first time.
What are you making, hush puppies?
Yeah.
You know what hush puppies are, right?
They'll find out.
So the reason why they call them hush puppies is because a long time ago, back in the day, they would have the stray dogs at the restaurants barking and asking for food. And so they just would take whatever was left over and make these little balls. Hush puppy.
How do you feel about this?
So is that fresh caught trout from Mark?
Yeah.
Today is a special day for us because we have our first patron coming aboard. We haven't even left the first marina yet, so we're pretty happy with that. Very experienced sailor, which we're in desperate need of to give us some help because we're learning. And we are absolutely stoked to have this person on board. Can you guess who this person may be?
It's from Exmouth.
If you know us, you may already know. It's pretty special for us because I actually had some beers the day before we left Exmouth in search of the dream, buying the boat. And I had some beers with this one person and they said to me, you know, what's your budget, this. And I told them, they were like, well, we'll see how you're going. Here we are.
Yes, we are actually going to pick up our first passport.
Let's go.
You.
All right, so we are on our way.
Well, we're just going through the ghetto and we haven't been shot at yet.
Oops. Yes.
Oh, halfway around the world, 24 hours later, and
friendly faces.
Welcome.
Donuts.
Show us what you brought.
Okay. So it looks like it's all been opened up by good old American Customs. The Kangaroo Cartel is bringing in its goods.
Holy dooly.
Well, you know, you just can never have enough Vegemite when you come to the other side of the world.
Oh my goodness. We're going to sink.
We've got good Aussie currency.
The boat's been saved by Vegemite.
We're just walking through the streets to post our registration papers to get stuff happening, so had to park miles away, but I've left Andy and Len back at the boat and I'm just in town trying to get it done, but it's very hard to park with a car. Registration documents going into the bin, going over there, it's $75 to get to Australia and it's a 1 week service, so good luck. Ready for this, Australia? Go get it, let's go. Putting the sail up in the marina, we are working on our reefing points. Going to go get some pulleys and set everything up so that it's going to be good for our first passage.
We took down our sails and put them in the car park. We had to take off the old sacrificial cover on the forward jib in order for the sail maker to apply a new one.
Oh no! Oh,
you tore it, you idiot.
I'm sorry.
Don't worry.
I tell you, I just have a look how it's bunched up and see how you're sitting on it. You put the tension on it the wrong way. They can repair it.
The issue is that material shouldn't tear that easily. If it does that, it's getting to the end of the block.
We dropped our sails at the sail maker and should have them back early next week.
We're just in recovery mode. What happened, Andy? What happened?
The solar panel blew overboard.
We had a squall. And the solar panel that was sitting here ready for mounting decided that it was going to sit over here. And now we're going fishing.
A big thanks to all our YouTube subscribers, Instagram followers, and of course our patrons.